by all indications and information that we can find, we will be the only educational facility in the country to have an electron beam welder.
In fact, I can only think of maybe one other that has access to it, and it's not in America.
Come October, one will be in America, thanks to a partnership between Pennsylvania College of Technology and Cambridge Vacuum Engineering. The England-based company is placing an electron beam welder in the college's expanded welding facility to spark educational options for students.
Tony Slater took the opportunity to advocate within CVE that it made a lot of sense to place this equipment in our facility. And so they worked out a deal that made it possible for us to partner together.
Penn College, after visiting them several months ago, realized their forward thinking and their attitude to the students would be a perfect match for us.
Annually, 200 plus students will experience the electron beam welder. That meets CVE's goal of increasing exposure to EB welding and the college's commitment of providing valuable real-world learning for its students.
Giving them the opportunity to have hands-on exposure to this stuff, I think, is going to bring them to a whole new level, and it's also going to take us along with it.
This diversifies our educational portfolio and opportunities to those students, the things that they get to experience.
That's why I use this.
Recently, Penn College welding faculty were the students. CVE field engineers spent 3 days training welding instructors on maintaining and operating an electron beam welder at the company's U.S. sales office in Massachusetts.
There's different aspects to this that we're not familiar with at this point in time that we're trying to get used to. A lot of it's the measuring of the units, and that's a little bit different than what we're all used to.
So now we're dealing with kilovolts and milliamps and things of that nature, where it's usually just a wire feed speed and the voltage. So we've got a little bit more complexity, which I kind of knew about, but the reality didn't set in until we got here and saw all the different variables that you have under your control.
We gave them a day of training yesterday and half a day this morning before I gave them a quiz. And they've scored higher than I've ever seen anyone do before.
Not surprised at all. These are individuals that are driven to experience new things, to develop and enhance their skill sets, their knowledge bases.
This gun that's inside the vacuum chamber is taking electrons. As it's basically shooting the electrons into the plate, it makes it hot. So as it makes it hot, then it penetrates down into the material and actually welds it together.
It's a very efficient energy transfer into the material, and consequently you can get very deep welds that don't necessarily have to be very wide.
When you actually pull it out and look at it, you have to basically really take a magnifying glass to see what it looks like, because it's such a small bead. That's what amazes me the most about the whole thing.
Electron beam welding is rooted in the aerospace and automotive sectors. It's often used to manufacture small components in a variety of fields.
Industry, they've been calling us and asking us if our students have any training on this type of equipment. Now we can actually say yes.
And now as they build that into their curriculum, they're then passing that rare skill on to students who can immediately take that out into their field and be a cut above other graduates.
I'm extremely proud. There's probably a better word for proud, a stronger word for proud, and that'd be where I'm at.
For PC Today, I'm Tom Speicher.